I want to think through the time versus money conversation a little bit differently to help us in that endeavor of, all right, if I'm shifting my mindset, if I'm shifting my thinking, my purpose around active versus passive income, but also time versus money, now I'm looking at money differently so that I can better accept and align with, yes, I absolutely want passive income. And yes, there are ways that I get to create that for myself that may be different than how others create it for themselves. And that's okay. I want to discuss some examples of trading time for money and what our time is worth, because that is also different for everyone. If you are the type of person where you are really good at budgeting, you want to be very economical in your consumption of resources, maybe things that you do is you drive an extra couple of miles to get gas that's at a cheaper place. Maybe you're the type of person where you spend 30 minutes or so to find coupons to save $15. Maybe you're the type of person where, hey, you know, a bigger expense, like for me, I just moved. So moving and saving money in terms of, okay, I will pack it all myself versus have someone pack it for me or have someone move it for me, saving that extra $500 or $1,000 instead of delegating it. Is that spending of time, whatever time that takes you to do those things, worth the dollars and cents that you're saving? Maybe. Maybe not. It really depends on what your time is worth. So there are always choices that we're going to get to make when spending time instead of money on doing something. But the question that really remains is it worth it? So let's do some math here. And the time invested per week that you spend working, I want you to tally it all up in income. So whether you make $10 an hour, $30 an hour, $50 an hour, $100 an hour, we're going to tally up how much you trade your time for those dollars that you get into your bank account and divide it. You come up with some sort of per hour figure. And for many of us, you know, maybe we don't get paid hourly. And so that's really going to be unique in terms of, well, I actually spend 50 hours a week doing my job. I don't get paid per hour, but I get a salary. So now divide that out into those hours that you're spending and what you're trading that time for. If we use the example of your time is worth $50 an hour, you might not continue wasting your time saving money if you're not saving at least $50 an hour. If you are spending 20, 30 minutes to drive to a less expensive gas station to save $5, not a good use of time, not worth it. You're spending 30 minutes to save $15, again, probably not a good use of time because your time is worth $50 an hour. So I hope this is landing as we're going through some of these examples. The more your time is worth based on that time trade-off, time versus money trade-off, the more you get to learn to delegate what that looks like for you. So delegation is going to be key here moving forward and really starting to align what it is that your actions are that you're taking to align time versus money trade-off. So stopping to recognize and be present to not living in contradiction of your values around time. So being aware of, being authentic in, hey, my time is very valuable to me. I just told myself that. So let's make decisions that are aligned with that and make it make sense. When we talk through passive income, I want to begin to cut that link between trading time for money. So what's really magical about creating passive income for yourself is now you don't have that time money trade-off conversation. You don't need it. Because if we were to visualize for a moment, you know, what would you do with your time if you didn't go to work? The question that remains and something that's definitely worth journaling about is, do you have a purpose in your life? Do you know what you would do to add value to the world if you didn't have to go to work? So I want you to spend some time thinking through this, because this is really where we want to drive your passion, what your why is. Finding fulfillment is going to be very important in this conversation with yourself. And there's no right or wrong answer. That is the one thing I can't give you the answer on, is what brings you fulfillment. For some of my clients, it is taking their education, their knowledge, their expertise around the environment to another level in a nonprofit. For some of my clients, it is, hey, I love to teach others. I have a great depth of knowledge in XYZ topic. And although I might do ABC in my day job, I love doing XYZ in my spare time. So how do I create an income source around this and let that income source run its course on its own without me having to be present in the seat to do it? So that would be in the form of like building a course, for example. Then we want to take that to another level of, if money didn't even exist, just forget money exists for a moment, let's visualize what that would be looking like. How would you spend your time? Would you travel everywhere? What would you do? How would you do it? Who would you do it with? And create that kind of experience and visualization in your mind. For me, it is absolutely travel. It is see different cultures, meet different people, understand what they do day to day, understand our differences, share my own stories. That entire experience of life is what I love to do on a day-to-day basis. Here's another way to frame it. If you won $100 million in the lotto, what would you do first? And then secondly, what would you do later? So if at first you have $100 million hit your world, and the first thing you want to go do is go on a shopping spree, that would be me. Amen. Let's go get all the shoes. What's the next thing you would do after you've satisfied that probably consumerism need, which we all have, especially in the environment that we're in the United States of America, consumerism runs rampant. What would you do next? What would you find fulfillment in and purpose in? For me, that is literally sitting here doing what I'm doing now. What I am completely and utterly inspired by is fulfilling the need to empower women to move into building wealth, to move into this element of confidence, empowerment around this topic. Because for so long we didn't have that, and now is our time. Now is our time to make that happen for ourselves.